I think one of the most important thing that Fiki Frames has achieved so far is putting India on the map and making sure in the last decade that everybody concerned with or connected with any form of entertainment have Fiki Frames on their calendar. And I believe that's a very, very big thing where India is also on the map of everybody in all segments of entertainment. Secondly, it has also focused on a few industries which are very weak and who initially cannot afford to have industry associations because they are very small. And Fiki has actually supported them to take the cause to the next level and also look at a representation to the government and discussing this cause and making sure that most of the things that are required for a generic industry like this are given and the support is given so that most of this segments like animation, gaming, visual effects and comics can go to the next level of its success. The thing is that you know we have been brought up in very different kind of environment from joint families to you know we've moved to storytelling on television about 2 decades ago, 3 decades ago. The fact is that our programming has completely been live action. And we are so used to it that having appreciation for the form of artistic storytelling in audiovisual form would always take time. We have examples of countries who have taken 30, 40, 50 years to go to the commercial success level. We have done fairly well. The exposure of digital content has been there for 1.5 decades. And we require the next level of maturity for audience to really appreciate what they see in the artistic audiovisual forms of storytelling. And I think whatever we have achieved in 15 years is remarkable. Never that, it's not enough, but the issue is we will have to wait for another decade or so before we actually exploit this content on various other platforms. See, the thing is, the animated content per se, no sooner the style is great, no matter what country or which region it comes from, it can be very easily dubbed and shown into multiple markets. The apprehension that people have is the cultural barrier. No sooner you create content which is unique, which is entertaining, which could be dubbed into any form, any language, I think it will find its way. But we need to have more and more content coming in. At this point in time, there is very less amount of content which is produced in this region. No sooner we are producing 10 to 15 shows a year, especially on television, which is easier to travel than the feature film, I think we will start finding our success. I think my learning is very simple. The thing is, unless and until you have marketing and distribution in place, it's always very difficult to... 1 minute. I think the... can you go back again? I think there are a few things which are very, very critical. The marketing and distribution in the broadcasting is the key to the success of the television. And I think to have at least few markets participating into the production is a key to the success of any of the properties. So one should look at a distribution and some broadcasters on board before any show is started. And I think that's something which would help taking the show to the next level in a very, very big way. Well, we have taken up the matter with the government in various levels. We have spoken about how animation, gaming, visual effects, and comics can be given a 10-year tax holiday to bring, a level playing field over a period of time. At the same time, that would encourage people to create co-produce content as well as original content from here and register the IPs in India. As well as do outsourcing. So there are three different models that are working. Everybody will have a level playing field. Right now it's more skewed only till outsourcing, and there's no incentive for creating original content. So one thing is that. Second thing is that we have also requested for a fund to be formed, which can actually participate directly into the equity of the shows. That would help and support several studios and individual artists create path-breaking content from here.
So finally, what is it that you tell your foreign visitors why they should attend?
I think one thing is very clear that the who's who of the industry is here. And one key thing is that it's a 3 days sessions, as well as the location is such that one can have one-on-one meetings very easily. At the same time, the pulse of the market can be felt very easy when you do one single visit. And if you come for a week at this time, you can also have time to go and visit the studios. So you can actually do a good amount of recce and finalize the deals of co-productions or production with Indian studios, which is very profitable at this point in time to do production work in India. So I think overall, it's very important for them to judge. In one single visit, they are not only able to meet a lot of people, but they are also able to have one-on-one meetings and also studio visits to understand how this is functioning. So I think that's why Frames is very, very critical. Thanks.